Okay, Ring Magazine did a post. If you were a fighter, who would you want to train with? Who would you want to train with? Not from this gym.
Not
if you were a fighter.
Gym?
Yeah.
There's a few guys that, but look, obviously I have personal relationships with like other trainers and stuff that are cool. Like Marcos, I know Marcos for a long time. So I would pick Marcos. Rudy Hernandez is a good coach. He's really good friends with my dad and, you know, he's cool.
I've never seen him in a corner. I've seen him always a cut man.
No, Rudy helps as a cut man a lot, like for the UFC.
I've seen that.
Other fighters. But
yeah.
He's a head coach for, you know, for Junto and Princesa, who are world champions.
Okay.
So, I Rudy, Marcos, I don't know. Who else has, okay, but if I had to pick somebody that I absolutely don't know and I've never even like talked to, I would probably pick, is there anybody, does Nacho count?
Yeah.
Nacho. Beristáin.
Of course he counts. Nacho. He's an icon.
No, but I'm saying, I don't think he's an active coach right now, is he?
He's always active.
Is he?
Yeah, okay, he still has fire.
If you want to count that, I'll pick Nacho.
He's a funny guy. I like him.
Yeah, he is.
He has a good sense of humor.
He's a badass coach. He's a legend.
It's a good choice.
Yeah, I'll pick Nacho. But if you told me, I'll pick the other two, Mac and Rudy.
But that's because you know them and they're...
Yeah, because I know them. And I know they're good coaches. The other guys, like, I don't know anybody else. I'm not going to pick anybody else.
Hey, if you could have any coach in the world that's not Robert Garcia, who would you go with? What do you mean you don't know? You have to know.
He's got the charisma of a fucking rock.
Did he tell you the story with the jacket?
What jacket?
I told him, oh, you want a charisma? He goes, no, I found it in the bus. He jacked it.
He stole it from somebody.
Hey.
Oh, shit.
But he wears it all the time with pride.
Yeah,
I think he's supposed to win the jacket.
He does have a bunch of them. He's won like, how many national titles have you won?
How do you win national titles when he's 48, like 9 years old?
He's won the silver gloves. The silver gloves are tough. How many times you won the silver gloves? Twice? The silver gloves are tough because it's like four little mini tournaments within the tournament.
Wow.
So that one's tough and he's won it twice already. And then he won two Junior Olympics. So he's 2-2.
What's up, Louis? Who's his favorite fighter? I know, I'm joking. Who's his favorite fighter?
This?
What do you think? Yeah.
I think Tank.
Who's your favorite fighter? You like Crawford? Why?
He's not too flashy. He's just normal.
He's boring. He loves Crawford because he's boring. What happens when...
I thought you were going to say Tank. I said I thought his favorite fighter would be Tank.
You like Crawford?
Tank.
Tank's very flashy and very powerful and very talented. Tank's a pound-for-pound king for me. Let me ask you this. What happens when Crawford fights Canelo? He said Canelo by stoppage.
Crawford, he's been cracked, so I think Canelo too.
You say Crawford cannot crack?
No, I say Crawford being cracked.
He's been cracked by who?
I forgot his name, but he's been cracked by some fighter, and then Canelo has a chin, so I think he can.
Pita, he said Crawford doesn't have a chin, so he got Canelo by You just said someone cracked him. Huh?
No, I forgot his name. I don't know.
You talking about Egas Kavalauskas or Madrimov?
I saw him somewhere. I know.
Yesterday, we told him I'm coming early, and then once we got here, we're like, fuck, we need somebody.
David, what's your record now?
Right now, I'm 6-1.
That's badass. Keep it going. What's the next fight?
October 9th.
You're signed with a major management, right? They're famous? They have a lot of big names. They have Teofimo, right?
Yeah.
Who else?
They got a lot of guys.
You got a lot of guys. So you have a big fight coming up?
They have some guys that we have. Javi Milwaukee and Little Milwaukee. They got both of them.
And they also have...
Who else do they have that's here?
They had Mireles? No.
Mireles, I don't know if they still have him or I don't know what's going on with him.
But you're from East LA, right?
Yeah, East LA.
And you drive every day like 2 hours to be here?
No.
He lives here in San Jacinto?
I just moved out here Riverside.
Okay, but before that, you used to drive?
Yeah, before I used to drive all the way out here.
I do that drive when I come here. It's not easy.
I don't like it.
One stall, one this, and the drive's like 2 hours.
Where?
LA.
Oh, yeah.
And sometimes it's not even an accident.
Yeah, sometimes.
And then, Pita, there'll be some cop park like on the side of the freeway, and everybody slows down all of a sudden.
Yeah.
How's your brother doing?
He's doing good.
Is he fighting soon?
Yeah, he might be fighting before this year ends.
Is he like 16-0? What's his record?
His record is moved up to 19, I believe.
19-0. Yeah. What weight? 47?
40.
40. 40. And then you have a cousin also that's very good, right?
Yeah, I have a cousin, two cousins, Chantel Navarro and Steven Navarro.
Steven Navarro has a lot of buzz behind him.
Steven's doing very good right now.
So if there's a family reunion and someone breaks in, who gives them the worst ass beating? your dad. Teddy Atlas is in the gym today. Doesn't that guy look like him with the white hair? You don't see, but Pita, you know everybody's names. I'm very impressed.
No, I don't know. I know them. I see them. Yeah. I've seen them somewhere, but I don't know where I know a lot of these people. But it's because we don't, like, we separated the groups. Today, Friday, everybody's training together because we have to leave later tonight.
Yeah,
But usually we attend, we split them up. Now, it's kind of a little bit more private. We're just Duarte, Jose, and Bam training, and Raymond training on their own. And then in the afternoons, we have the rest of the
everybody. Office. Smart.
Yeah.
I saw Chop Chop just walked in the door. Chop, you have a fight already, right? December? You have a fight?
Yeah, December.
Okay, December. You and Pita on a basketball court. Who wins and why?
Pita, you be balling?
No. He could play. How about if you spar Pita? Who would do good?
Nah, I wouldn't spar Pita.
You know, I saw a video of him at 7 years old. He had knockouts.
Yeah?
He put people asleep.
Yeah, Pita.
And you're amateurs. You knocked someone out. You were eight.
I was fucking 8 years old.
And you were knocking him out, Pita?
You stopped him. Yeah. You dropped him. Pita, I saw the video.
Hey, Pita, so we're having your first amateur fight.
But amateurs.
I didn't get shot twice.
Wait, really quick, Chop. Does he look like JoJo or like Eminem? What do you think?
Eminem.
You think so? maybe in that video, Stan.
Yeah, that one right there.
With Stan, is that the one with the fake Eminem or Slim Shady?
That's Slim Shady. Yeah, that's Slim Shady.
With the middle.
Yes.
Stan, the number one fan. Hey, are you a fan of Eminem? Why? What's his favorite song?
A good song.
Yeah, that's not from 30 years ago.
From now?
That's recently.
Recently,
that's his. You like what's that? One shot, one opportunity. I'm Slim Shady.
It's outplayed, but it's cool.
What do you play when you go running?
I'm playing calm music.
Calm music?
Yeah.
Like what's calm music?
It's like calm music, like chill music.
Like what? Give me like who's that artist?
Oldies.
What's oldies for you?
Like Brian Wood. Even older.
You listen to what's the guy's name?
R. Kelly?
R. Kelly? What is it? What the fuck? Arthur the Chili Man? What is it?
R3 the Chili Man.
So I don't know what that is. He likes to listen to slow dance music when he goes running. That's alright. Hey, whatever gets. You know what? Some people. Do you like running, Louis?
I don't
know. Some people hate running. So, like a lot of boxers like to play basketball or soccer. It's just more interesting. Yeah.
Oh, I thought you said running, Louis. But I don't know what it is.
Running.
I mean, yeah, just days. There's like anything else. I guess I love it, but.